Hey you guys, welcome back to my channel. Today is a video, as you guys can see below, about my portfolio photo shoot. I wanted to show you guys a BTS of me doing a photo shoot, but then I realized, A, this is a portfolio shoot, so this is different than a lot of the shoots that I just do for myself. These are for my agencies, which got me to thinking, you guys, a lot of you guys are aspiring plus size models or just models in general. And so I thought that along this video at the end, I would just give you guys some brief tips. If you guys did not know, I am the creator of the first ever How to Become a Plus Size Model class. There's a few other classes like it now, but I am the first one and I am the only plus size model teaching how to become a plus size model. So, not only that, but if you guys didn't know, you can also email me at HayleyHermsOfficial@yahoo.com or management@HayleyHerms.com and ask me for pricings for one-on-one Skype sessions. And I just teach everything from how to become a plus size model, how to pose, how to book agencies, how to find work, whether you're in a small city, a big city. I cover so much stuff, so I'm gonna stop talking. Take a look at the link below. We're just gonna jump in this video, and at the end of the video, you guys are gonna get some tips and tricks of how you can build your portfolio photo shoot to hopefully land an agency, or for your already existing agency. If it's your first time building a portfolio, maybe this might be helpful for you. Let's go. So before a really important shoot, I like to do the under eyes and then usually some skin stuff. It's really important that makeup looks really good on your skin when you treat your skin really good. So face care is like essential to having great makeup done. So I'm using the Wander Gold Baggage Eye Claim under eye mask. I really like them. This is not sponsored, just my favorite. So the day before a photo shoot, I like to be really prepared. I have my purse. This is all my stuff that I'm gonna bring to the photo shoot. I like to bring a suitcase because it's easy to travel around with. The bags aren't heavy on your shoulder, and sometimes when you have heavy bags and you're about to model, they leave red marks on your skin, and you don't want that. I have my camera and vlog stuff set up in a pile, and then a box I needed. Ooh, and that is my alarm. So the next thing is I always set my alarms to keep me on track. I know you can't see it, but and then just, here we go. And we're off. Time to go to the photo shoot, you guys. For photo shoots, I always like to wear something comfy. When doing your makeup and your hair, you're just sitting there for hours. You don't wanna wear something you're uncomfortable with. And I don't wear a bra when I get my hair and makeup done, just in case, because sometimes bras can leave red line marks or under boob marks. So it's really important that you don't have any marks on your body if you don't have to. And I think that's just a helpful tidbit. Yeah, so wear comfy clothes. Don't wear a bra while getting your hair and makeup done. And let's roll, baby.
So this is the studio we're recording in today.
So some of the looks we have, so this is for my agency. We have lots of cute little dresses and a black jumpsuit situation, a green dress corduroy belt situation. We're not gonna shoot all of these. Ashley.
Hi.
And Amanda's doing the amazing hair. Anastasia's back there.
Working hard for the money.
We'll be right back. this is our second
look. We have a high pony, jumpsuit situation, and some heels. Just zoom.
If you are watching this, you either just saw the portfolio shoot or you skipped past it and just wanted to come here for the tips, which I don't care and I don't blame you. Either way, you clicked it. Now, on to the tips. So I wanted to give you guys 5 tips when creating your portfolio shoot. Number 1, headshot is your most important photo and typically the most sent around of you. So make sure you guys get a really good, clean, happy commercial photo shoot. A majority of you guys are doing commercial work, so I'm gonna speak to the majority. The only exceptions would be like if you're doing high fashion or if you were doing alternative modeling, like Hot Topic kind of. But other than that, for any other type of modeling, you're gonna really need a clean, happy, natural headshot. This photo is gonna be the photo that you put on all your websites that agencies or yourself are gonna send out to everyone. So just make sure you get a really good headshot. Second, try to have a range of photos to show you can do a range of work unless you guys want to strictly stick to one type of modeling. So for example, I have a friend who only does high fashion modeling, so you will only see her at a very high conceptual, artistic type of photo, like an avant-garde type of photo shoot. You won't see her doing any commercial work or magazines or print stuff like that unless it is like a Vogue type situation, which is so cool because so like what I did today, this is the staple portfolio shoot that is gonna get me most of my commercial work and get me most of my gigs. But if I do want to appeal to a Hot Topic or high fashion, or I want to get hired by beauty companies, you know, then those are the type of photos that I also need to show. So if I wanted to start doing a bunch of beauty shoots like for CoverGirl or Revlon or something, then I need to do a lot of beauty shoots. Beauty shoots are just basically glam shoots from the neck up and just modeling the makeup that you have on. But anyways, I dive all of this, like I know I'm gonna say this a lot, but I dive in so much detail into my plus size modeling class and in my Skype sessions one-on-one with my clients. So if you guys, again, wanna check those out below, I dive so much detail. If you guys have questions, I can try to answer them below, but you know, sometimes the questions are so broad and all that fun stuff, it's better if you just take my modeling class. Third tip. In a portfolio, it's key to have commercial photos. Smile, clean, happy, light makeup. It's important to have a blank canvas photos so clients can picture you as their vision. Staple portfolio shoot, you wanna have clean makeup. So that doesn't mean don't have any makeup, it just means it needs to look so natural. Your eyeshadow needs to be very light. Like, there's definitely a certain way for portfolio makeup. So I always suggest, if you're doing your portfolio photo shoot, always have hair and makeup. Not even like the highest, like most amazing makeup artists for their own makeup lines do their own makeup. They hire someone else. So don't put your stress on yourself. Like, definitely hire someone that can do that for you. But essentially the whole point of saying that is clients, as crazy as it sounds, brands and clients and influencer companies, like all of those types of peoples, they don't always have imaginations. So they need to see blank photos. So like if they do have a really like swimsuit, girly look in their head, they can imagine you like that. Or if you're doing a Hot Topic and they wanna see you as like a goth queen, like they wanna see as a bare minimum clean slate you so that they can imagine you how they see you. And basically you don't wanna shove an idea like down them. Like if I was like trying to like model from for Target, I wouldn't do an alternative photo shoot because how would Target ever imagine me without all that makeup on? You know what I mean? You catch my drift? I don't know. I talk too much. Number four. Take new portfolio shots every 6 to 12 months depending on how fast your appearance changes. Current photos are important. So I will not stress this enough. I have had stories from my agencies that have told me that models will show up and even their hair root color isn't the same as their photos and brands will freak out. Or they lied about their height, like by 1 inch, a brand like freaked out, sent the model home. So, you know, you wouldn't think you would be that strict, but people in the fashion world can be that strict. They want what they want. If you don't look like your picture, it's gonna be a problem. So luckily for me, like I said, once or twice a year, you should update a portfolio shoot. Lucky for me, I don't dye my hair, and I usually keep my hair within the same 3 to 4 inches length. So I never let it get past like too much like here, but I never like it shorter than here so that I don't have to take too many portfolio shoots. But if you are someone who likes to dye your hair a lot, like from black or orange or green, like even it doesn't even matter if you're just doing a simple color like blonde to black, you know what I mean? You have to do new portfolio shoots. Or, I know this is a touchy subject, but if you gain 50 pounds, you need new portfolio photos so that brands can see what you actually look like. If you're someone who fluctuates weight, I talk about this in my modeling class, like I used to fluctuate a lot and not by like just like 10, 15 pounds. I'd go up 30 pounds, I'd go down 30 pounds. So I had portfolio shoots of me at both weights. So if I did fluctuate up, I'd call my agency and be like, hey, I gained 20 pounds, let's use these photos. Take those down on the website, they put up the new photos. Hey, I lost 30 pounds. They take my old photos, they put those ones up. So it works out. So like I said, do a new portfolio shoot once or twice a year so they can keep up with your current image, because you'd hate to show up on set and a brand to look at you and be like, this is not what I saw in a picture. And lastly, typical portfolio photos are pretty basic with standard pieces. White tank tops, jeans, or black jeans, solid color coats, dresses, shirts. So I'm gonna be posting all my portfolio photos in a few weeks. This vlog will probably come out before the portfolio photos come out. So make sure you guys follow me on Instagram, not just promo, but genuinely follow me on Instagram so you can see my new portfolio shots. As you guys can see, the outfits though, they're neutral. So we started with the first look, and that is the white tank top and the jeans. Those are gonna be like, that's what you're gonna wear to auditions. That's gonna be your casting photo because it's blank. You're a canvas, so the brands can see you. So I'd always suggest your first look to be a jean look and a neutral, either a black or a neutral gray or green or a white tank top or some kind of shirt that really shows off your body. It could be long sleeve, but you wanna make sure it isn't loose. Like I know my shirt's tucked in the front so you can see that silhouette, but if I untucked that shirt, you wouldn't see my silhouette. Brands would have no idea what my body looked like. So make sure it's form-fitting and neutral. Then for my following looks, I did basically a couple, so this is more so my spring summer portfolio. So we're doing spring summer looks. So these were some of the images that my agencies pulled for me and said, we want pictures like this. So of course for spring summer, we had to get a dress. And so as you can see, this dress is white and blue, but mostly appeals off of blue. It's like a neutral color blue. It's not too bright, it's not too royal. So it's something that's just a very classic key. I call it like my nice lady look. Just very being able to appeal to the commercial mass, like the Targets, the JCPenney's, the Macy's, the Lane Bryant's. And then we have another dress, like the mint dress. And again, that was a really standout piece, but it still hugged my body. The color was still neutral. It complemented my hair, it complemented my eyes. Make sure you guys pick neutral colors that complement your skin tone or your eyes or your hair color. These are all things to think about. And then what else did we have looks? And we had like one other look. What was it? Oh, the black jumpsuit. So then again, black, a neutral basic color. It's easy to imagine, but this time I did a ponytail so that you could really see my face and see my features. So it's nice to switch up the looks a little bit. I did have my hair down in mostly of the other photos, but it was nice to have one of the looks to switch up if you can. When doing a portfolio shoot, I recommend that you definitely do 2 to 4 different looks. Essentially 3 would be a great number. Try to get like a dress in there. And then of course, like I said, number one foremost, get the jean and the neutral top combo, because that's gonna be your number one. Then get a dress in there, maybe if you can do a swim or a lingerie or an active wear. So that's all the tips I have. If you're really serious about becoming a plus size model, not to just promo myself, but I go so much further into depth about all these topics and building your portfolio in my class, how to find your resources, how to be on a low budget, how to find everything. Like, you guys, like, I've been in the modeling industry for over 10 years now. I've seen everything before and after the internet. I know how it all works, and it's a crazy journey. So if you're interested in becoming an aspiring plus size model, click the link below to see my past classes, or hit me up at HayleyHermsOfficial@yahoo.com or management@HayleyHerms.com to get prices for my one-on-one Skype sessions or FaceTime sessions. And if you're in the Los Angeles area, I also do meet one-on-one person sessions. And I do have client trials if you guys want to talk to some previous clients that can give you guys info on that. Anyways, thank you guys for watching. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe. Let me know in the comments if you thought this was helpful and all your thoughts. I love hearing from you guys. Hope you have a great night. Yes!